The marketing research process. Before we discuss the process in marketing research, let us discuss its objectives and purpose. Marketing research is a useful and necessary tool for helping marketers and an organization's executive leadership make wise decisions. It details the procedures necessary for obtaining the required information. Its purpose is to design a study that will test the hypotheses of interest, determine possible answers to the research questions, and provide the information needed for decision-making. The marketing research process starts by identifying the problem, then developing the research plan, conducting research, analyzing and reporting the findings, and finally, putting research into action. Stage 1. Identify the problem. The goal at this stage is to generate a set of preliminary, big-picture questions that will frame your research inquiry. It helps clarify the scope of the project, which identifies the following questions. Whom do you need to talk to? What information may be available? And where to look for the information you don't have? The market research process begins with the identification of a problem faced by the company. A clear definition of the problem helps the researcher in all subsequent research efforts, including setting proper research objectives, determining the techniques to be used, and collecting the extent of information. Project objectives. There are three types of objectives that can be deployed in marketing research. 1. Exploratory research. It is used to define a problem or scout opportunities better. In-depth interviews and discussions groups are commonly used. 2. Descriptive research. Used to assess a situation in the marketplace. Methods include personal interviews and surveys. 3. Causal research. It is for testing cause and effect relationships. Typically through estimation. Research questions. What specific information, guidance, or recommendations need to come out of the research? It clarifies the scope of the projects by identifying what questions need to be answered. 2. Develop the research plan. The goal at this stage is to include in the research plan the overall purpose of the research and how the outputs will be used and communicated, the types and sources of data needed. Questions to consider at this stage are: Who needs to be involved in the research process? What do you intend to do with the information? When, why, and what format will they need the information? Developing the research plan is a crucial stage, as it will guide you on what important information you need to answer your question and achieve your goals. This stage will help you plan the overall research, including the budget and time frame. Data collection is a crucial step in the research process, because it enables the generation of insights that will influence the marketing strategy. It is essential to plan on how you will collect the data. And two types of data can be gathered. Secondary research analyzes information that has already been collected, while primary research collects data captured expressly for research inquiry. You also need to plan which responsible parties will conduct research activities such as data collection and data analysis. Who will interpret the research and how it will be reported? Number 3. Conduct research. Conducting research begins to generate information that helps answer your urgent marketing questions. Reviewing information gathered from secondary data, primary research, and from the marketing research methods and techniques. This is the stage where you will review all gathered information from both secondary and primary research. The most common methods and techniques used in marketing research are: Survey, known as the questionnaire method, refers to all methods of obtaining the needed information through asking the questions to the respondents. Second, observation is a method that places an observer, human or machine, to watch and record what is happening. The third method is the experimental method, is the procedure of carrying out the best possible solution to a given problem on a small scale. The aim is to determine whether the tentative conclusions reached can be proved in actual conditions. In-depth interviews. It is a technique of getting the replies from the respondents in an atmosphere of freedom and relaxation. It is a form of unstructured research or interview. It is non-directive interview where the respondent is being urged to talk the near saying yes or no for a specific question. And the last is projective techniques, which are tests conducted wherein the respondents are encouraged to project their feelings, attitudes, impressions, motives, reactions, and the like to a third person or an object. The stage 4 is to analyze and report findings. Analyzing the data obtained in a market survey involves transforming the primary and or secondary data into useful information and insights that answer the research questions. This information is condensed into a format to be used by managers, usually a presentation or detailed report. The analysis starts with formatting, cleaning, and editing the data to make sure that it's suitable for whatever analytical techniques are being used. In this process, you will have a clearer answer to your question on the initial stage of marketing research. Common analytical techniques include regression analysis, it used to determine correlations between factors, conjoint analysis is to determine trade-offs and priorities, predictive modeling is used to anticipate patterns and causality, and analysis of unstructured data such as internet search terms or social media posts to provide context and meaning around what people say and do. Interpretation of results. Who will be responsible for interpreting the results? It is usually the individuals with a good working knowledge of data to give significant insights and suggest recommendation from the research findings. Report and recommendations. During the report preparation and presentation step, the entire project should be documented in a written report that addresses the specific research questions identified, describes the approach, the research design, data collection, and data analysis procedures adopted, and presents the results and the major findings. This permanent document is also helpful because it can be easily referenced by others who may not have been part of the research. The findings should be presented in a comprehensible format so that they can be readily used in the decision-making process. In addition, an oral presentation should be made to management using tables, figures, and graphs to enhance clarity and impact. The last stage is to put research into action. It is essential to help the managers understand the research, as it may be too technical for them. Keep in mind that the marketing research results are never translated into management action. It should be explained thoroughly how it will benefit the company from the new path. To plan effectively, it is advisable to have the results accessible to managers and the execution team to help them map strategies and tactics and maximize the use of available resources. Course adjustment and execution. When the researchers fail to provide valuable insights or solutions to the problem, the managers must adjust the course towards the desired outcome.